Mr. David Rivard, if you could join us, please. Chief Executive Director of Toronto Children's Aid Society.
And I'm sure that applause is because I'm the last speaker to come up. So it was very encouraging to see Chief Blair up here because he was on our board of directors for a period of 5 years. And the Children's Aid Society of Toronto is one of the largest children's aid societies in North America. And our vision really looks at working in excellence and working in partnership. We try and create a city where children are safe, families are strong, and communities are supported. It's an honor for me to be here this evening and to share the stage with so many distinguished guests. And this past summer, we had a representation, and you saw some of us in the video doing some very interesting dancing techniques and so on. But there were representatives from 5 children's aid societies in Toronto and the GTA and from our provincial association, the Ontario Association of Children's Aid Societies, that had the opportunity to visit Turkey. It was a wonderful experience for all of us, and again, I think you got a sense of that from some of the other speakers this evening. It was an historic exchange for us because this was really the first opportunity for children's aid societies, to my knowledge in Canada, to have an opportunity to meet with our counterparts in Turkey to talk about issues impacting on children and families. We found this to be a very rewarding experience and certainly appreciate the support of CIDC, whose really the support would not have allowed us to embark on this very important journey. To learn about a country as diverse as Turkey firsthand was indeed a privilege. Diversity from a distance and without understanding, especially in politics, faiths, practices, and customs, can often bring with it fear. The fact that Canadian Intercultural Dialogue Center addresses this issue face-to-face is something we all marveled at throughout our experience. Every day could not have been more special. We all experienced Turkey and its people as very vibrant and full of energy. In the field of social services, it's very rewarding to see Turkey is moving forward with a new vision for children's services and a policy called Children First, which really builds on traditional family values and cultures, strengthens the youth justice system, youth rights, and provides support to families to care for their children by implementing new minimum protection standards. We were privileged to see firsthand the best that Turkey offers its foster children, the developmentally challenged, the aged, and the infirmed. It was very encouraging to see the progress made thus far in an effort to prevent the mistreatment of children and the improvement of overall family well-being. Veryl, you and the CIDC are to be commended for your powerful vision and the manner of outreach to us in keeping with your mandate of achieving strength for your people here and abroad. I must say, we were very impressed with CIDC's overall mission of bringing together communities in order to promote compassion, cooperation, partnership, and community service through intercultural dialogue and conversation. For those of you who may not know, we toured Istanbul, Cappadocia, Konya, Ankara, Antalya, Izmir, and Ephesus. When we left Canada on July 3rd, we had no idea what a life-enriching and changing experience would lie ahead of us. The sights were extraordinary. The people, the history, and culture truly amazing. Our stories that cover the 10-day trip would be too numerous to tell you in the brief time Veryl said I had to speak. On behalf of Paul Zarnke and his wife, Donna, if you could please stand, or at least Paul's with the Peel Children's Aid Society, Ken Richard, who's with Native Child and Family Services of Toronto and unfortunately couldn't be here this evening, and his friend Susan Spiegel. Susan? Patrick Lake from the York Children's Aid Society. Virginia Rowden and her husband, John. And Virginia's with the Ontario Association of Children's Aid Society. Daniel Moore and his wife, Louise. And Daniel's with the Guelph Child and Family Services. And my lovely, lovely wife, Nadia, and I. We were, again, deeply appreciative of the opportunity provided to us this past summer. Visiting Turkey the way we did was something beyond our expectations. and was certainly the trip of a lifetime for all of us. Thank you very much. I would be remiss if I also did not acknowledge Halim and his wife, Nurten, who joined us on this journey, and also, I would say, who were very patient in answering our many, many questions about Turkish customs. They and their six children, including Yusuf, who I understand is here this evening, Halim, Betul, Cody, Kyler, and Savannah, really demonstrated for us a beautiful, loving, and caring family. We were also blessed to be able to share, along with extended family and friends, in a very important ceremony that really acknowledged the adoption of your three children and really allowing them in your community to welcome them. To the people who sponsored us on behalf of our group, I thank you also. Our sponsors and their families were also extraordinary and unforgettable in their hospitality. Their generosity touched us deeply and was so unexpected. We are also so grateful to each and every one of them for their financial support, their time, delicious food, bountiful gifts, and friendship. They made the trip possible and very, very special for us. Also, Simi, wherever you are, and your brother, walk the paths of many great sites and sacred places with us, taking many, many pictures and filming our every step. Thank you for your kindness and friendship to us along the way and now. To those of you who know Varol, you are aware of how kind and an exceptional human being he is. Varol, words will never be enough to express our thanks to you for all you did for us each and every day. You were amazing and made the trip very special. Thank you so much. We are blessed by your continued friendship and look forward to remaining a part of your family. To all the friends of the CIDC, may goodness and friendship continue to foster growth and success in all of your endeavors with one another, and most importantly, for others. Thank you.